Here are five things you might want to know about the RMS Straight Up Volumizing Peptide Mascara before you buy it. Hi friends, and welcome back to the channel. I'm Britt, creator of The Style Shaker, and you are probably in the market for a new cleaner mascara. I'm gonna run through my scorecard and the five things that I want you to know about this product before you potentially buy it. At the very end, I give you my honest opinion on whether or not I would buy it. This was gifted to me. I was under no obligation to review it. You're still getting my honest opinion. And also, at the end of this video, I'm gonna give you some recommendations on the products that I would buy over and over again, or what I think would be comparable to this for you if you're still in the market and looking for the right mascara. But only 30 to 40 products make their way onto the Brit's Picks page every season. It's the one pager where I have all of my current favorites all in one spot for you, so you can check that out. Link is below there. So let's see if this mascara will make the cut for Brit's Picks, but more importantly, is it gonna be a fit for you? First up, ingredients. Kind of bummed out here. I mean, there's a lot of different types of ingredients in here. Also, read the disclaimer on the screen, please. Not a cosmetic chemist. Nope. They use the term fragrance and parfum on here. I have asked the brand, what's up? What does that entail? Because that could be a number of different things. I still have not heard back. This was weeks ago. I've been trying this for like basically 2 months. Yeah, that's pretty much a non-negotiable for me. If you're okay with that, or maybe you hear back from them, please share, because they're not getting back to me. Continue on, because the performance was not bad at all. But yeah, kind of bummed about that. Thanks, RMS. Thanks. And I know what you're thinking. Well, maybe I don't, but I would have thought, eh, it just goes on your lashes, right? It's like not all over your face. Well, here's the thing. Your eyes are basically holes on your face. I've learned this after going through a pandemic. This is why they say don't touch your eyes or your mouth. So yes, it's important what is there. And also, it can irritate your eyes. Contact lens wear, sensitive eyes. Now let's get into application. All right, you're gonna wanna know how this applies. Different mascaras apply very differently. Sometimes based off of a formula, it can be wet or thick. Sometimes based off of a brush, sometimes based off of a booth. Soft, tapered, thick brush. Loved the brush here. It's more of a classic shape. It's easy to apply. It's not one of those hard silicone brushes. Everyone has a thing when it comes to a mascara brush. Certain people like different brushes. I'm a fan of this, the softness, yes. The formula is not too wet, it is not too thick, it was not clumpy, it did not mess around with me, it was very easy to deposit on the lash. A lot of it went on when I did apply, but not too much. It did a very, very good job with application. It received a 5 out of 5 overall, very good job. Next up, volume, right? We all want some volume. Some people really don't want a lot of volume. So I like a lot of volume, but some people don't want it. To each their own. Claim, volume, all the claims are the same at this point, aren't they? Volume, length, definition, and lift for luscious and dramatic lashes. Here's the deal. One coat showed soft volume. It was there, it was impactful. It wasn't a whoa, but it was there. It was natural looking. Second coat, it built up nicely, more so at the base of the lash, kind of got a little bit fluffier. It kind of got a little bit more volume, but it wasn't crazy intense volume. Overall, I would say it was a clean looking, no clumpies, no nothing like that, natural looking mascara that provided a subtle amount of volume. You could see it, but it just wasn't overboard or anything like that. I am not, however, seeing luscious and dramatic lashes, but I feel like that terminology can be a little subjective, so we'll just, I gave it a 3 out of 5. A length. I think it did better on length, to be honest with you. I think it performed a little bit better in lengthening than it did on volume. I could absolutely see lengthening with the first application of this product. I also happen to love when mascaras give that little flip at the end, that little flick of lift. This did that. Very cool. Really liked it. Also, you can press it when the formula is still wet. And it lifts it even more. You can do a lash curler, but I feel like the pressing after is a little bit less aggressive. That's just a second coat of mascara, not a whole lot more length. I really got the bulk of it in the first couple of applications. Overall for length, I gave it a 4 out of 5. Wear test. This is very impressive. Not a flake, not a thing, not a smudge, nothing. Okay, so it's the end of the day. There is no flaking. There is no smudging. There's not, this mascara holds up really well. So, so well. Very impressed. I've done it for 2 weeks, I've worn it for 2 weeks, nothing. 5 out of 5. If you suffer from smudges and things falling off your face, what? I don't know. Basically, it held up all day. The final score here, if I'm not looking at the glaring word parfum fragrance, is a 17 out of 20. So like I said, The performance, real good. Brand transparency, not real good. Matter of fact, it was pretty bad. Also, no refills. So final verdict, honestly, would I buy it again? If you know me, which if you've been watching this channel for 5 years, you know I'm gonna say no because they weren't transparent. Fragrance could be nothing major, could be proprietary. I understand the game, guys. I get it. But I wanna know what I'm putting in my eye holes. That's a quote. I will say it was a vast improvement from their first mascara, which I tried a long time ago. Didn't understand how to post reviews yet at that point, but I tried it. I did not like it. Also, the refills. I have some refills that I can do. The Kira Weiss mascara, you will see it on the Brits Picks page. It's so good. It is very different from this, okay? Very, very different. But something I love, and it also has refills. A soft, kind of clean, defining mascara that I think is a really great option. There's always the Ilia Limitless Lash. The Sappho mascara is a beautiful mascara, which I think I need to re-review. I need to do an update over here. Honest Beauty, great mascara. Haven't tried it recently, so can't speak to that. But it comes with a primer. If you too are turned off by the fact that there are no refills and that they won't disclose all their ingredients, then those are some other options for you to check out. There is a mascara playlist over here. And again, you can go back onto the site and check out Brits Fix. There you have it. That is what the scorecard says. That is what I said. My word is not gospel, as you know. So I wanna know what you think about this mascara. Have you tried it? Do you love it? Are you pro RMS mascara? Do you have a different mascara that you love? And tell us why in the comments below. All of that information is like little pieces of gold. It is helpful for whoever is trying to figure it out in the clean beauty game. So we all could use the help, right? I know. Thank you so much for watching. If you found this review helpful and you want to keep seeing more of them, don't forget to take 2 seconds, hit that like button, subscribe to the channel. New videos come out every week. I'm gonna go put this away, test out some more in the test kitchen, and I will see you right back here real soon. Until then, bye.